Fab, let's talk about Mino Raiola. Before we get into him, let's say you love soccer, but you don't really know who Mino Raiola is, which you really should. Explain to us in layman terms, how influential, how powerful is Mino Raiola?
He's more than powerful. I think he's a genius, let me say, because he's doing things since many and many years with top players, and people are criticizing him in European football, always attacking him, football fans and people around football, but he's always doing his best for players. So he doesn't care about the clubs. He only cares about his clients, his players. And this is why top players many times go with Mino Raiola. Together with Jorge Mendes and with Jonathan Barnett, he's one of the three biggest agents in European football and world football, because he's an incredible power. He's very good with the strategies he does. For example, to take an example, Erling Haaland joins Borussia Dortmund when he had the chance to go to Juventus or maybe Manchester United. And he says, let's go to Borussia Dortmund, but with a release clause of 80 million in 2 years. And now this clause that is going to be valid in summer 2022 looks like an incredible opportunity. It's like a candy shop now for Haaland. And it's like a candy shop for money too, because it's going to be huge money for Haaland, for Mino Raiola, and for Borussia Dortmund too. So it's been an incredible strategy, and he's very good with this, with the strategy he does for his clients. And this is why top players are with him. We can mention many that he had, for example, Pavel Nedved, and now he's working with Juventus as vice president, but he's been a key client of Mino Raiola. He won the Ballon d'Or, so you're talking about a legendary player, but he already has many players for the future. So he's doing an incredible job, but his mentality is always to fight with the clubs to have the best deal for his clients. And it's not always easy to find this kind of agents, because many big agents we have in Europe are very good for the clubs and very good for the players. But he always wants the best for his clients. This is why he's different.
Give me a little list of who he represents. You mentioned Erling Haaland. Who else does he represent?
We can mention many. Paul Pogba. Also, we can mention Marco Verratti. We can mention Gianluigi Donnarumma. We have really many and many players.
Zlatan Ibrahimovic, I believe.
Zlatan Ibrahimovic, legendary. Yes, of course, always been with him. Also, players that will be for the future, because it's very good to find players for the future. For example, Xavi Simons, midfielder of Paris Saint-Germain. Mazraoui of Ajax, right back, interesting player. Stefan De Vrij, center back of Inter, who is doing great in Serie A since many, many years. He has many and many clients. We could spend the whole day mentioning players with him, and they are all top players. Alessio Romagnoli is the captain of AC Milan, so he has many and many players in Italy, and not only in Italy, also in Dutch leagues. For example, Ryan Gravenberch, the midfielder of Ajax, who will be the next big thing coming from Dutch football. Many and many players, many and many talents.
Well, the other part that you mentioned there, Fab, that I think is also really important to remember, is he's very good at building relationships, and I think that's a very important thing for him as he deals with clubs. And one particular relationship he has is with Joan Laporta, the Barcelona president. And they had a meeting, and you have explained it already on your program and your shows. Here we go. And of course, Twitter. And I would love to know, and the audience, tell us, the Que Golazo viewers and listeners as well, just the meaning behind this meeting. I presume it was obviously... Well, I don't presume, as you mentioned, it's Erling Haaland-esque, right? A meeting regarding him, but possibly other players. Is that right?
Yes. First of all, the relationship is the key word, as you mentioned, because the relationship between Joan Laporta, Barcelona president, and Mino Raiola is incredible. It was a meeting that was planned, so it was not like casual, because Laporta was in Italy for Pedri and for him receiving the golden boy. Yes, it was too many golden in the last month.
So many golden things.
Yes, and always to Pedri, so it's not easy to pick the right one.
That's true.
And so he did great, and so he was together with him in Torino, but the meeting was planned since one week. So this is why it was absolutely not casual. There was with him also Matteo Alemany, sport director of Barcelona, and Jordi Cruyff. So the whole Barcelona board, together with Laporta, meeting with Mino Raiola. Relationship is amazing also because, if you remember, in the first era of Juan Laporta as Barcelona president, they did many deals together. For example, Zlatan Ibrahimovic to Barcelona. Also Maxwell, the Brazilian left back, who joined Barcelona. He was a former client of Mino Raiola. So this is why the relationship is amazing. They were talking about, first of all, nothing advanced yet, so it was not the opportunity to make proposals or these kind of things. It was just because of the relationship. But asking about Erling Haaland's situation, it doesn't mean that Barcelona will be able to sign him. I want to be clear on this point, because we know that Barcelona are in trouble on financial situation. So let's see next summer how will be the situation, if they will be able to sell players, if they will be able to fix this situation. But they dream of Erling Haaland, as many other clubs, and so they asked about him. Mazraoui, right back of Ajax, out of contract in June 2022, could be a possibility, so they discussed about it. Xavi Simons, we mentioned him before, playing for Paris Saint-Germain, super talent, born in La Masia because he's coming from Barcelona Academy, and so they know him so well in Barca. And Mino Raiola has no plan to sign a new contract with Paris Saint-Germain for Xavi Simons if they don't guarantee to him that he will be part of the first team. And so this is why many clubs are interested in Barcelona, are also keeping information about Xavi Simons. So the relationship is super, and this is why they will be open to do some deals together. But at the moment, it's just about asking for information. For example, also about Paul Pogba, out of contract in June with Man United. He has a proposal to extend, but he's not decided yet what he wants to do. And so let's see what Barca will be able to do in maybe March, April, May, because as of now, they are not able to afford players like Haaland or Pogba. But let's see in the summer.
Well, that was where I was going there, because obviously it was an information-centric meeting. I remember, I do want to go back to Erling Haaland. Is there any way at all that you see Erling Haaland in Barcelona?
You know, I can tell you that as of now, in December, no, because they are in trouble on financial side. But Mino Raiola always made relationships with the key of his football strategy. And so he always bring his best players to clubs where he has the best relationship. It happened with Pogba, with Man United, because you remember at the point the relationship with Man United was amazing when they signed Pogba. The same happened with De Ligt, with Juventus. Matthijs De Ligt is another of the clients of Mino Raiola. The relationship with PSG is amazing, and Donnarumma is playing for PSG. So, you know, it's always about the relationship. So I want to say, as of now, no, because of the financial situation. But if Barca will be able in 7 months, in 8 months, to fix the situation and to pay for Erling Haaland, I'm sure that they will be in the race together with other clubs, because it's going to be a super open race. And nothing will be decided now in December or in January. Yeah? It will take time. So Haaland will not decide his next club right now.
Yeah, so these are just the steps that are being built in order to, you know, clubs to get information, people that, are, as you mentioned, that know Mino Raiola very well, and Mino Raiola assessing his options. I mean, he already did it even months ago, you know, just step by step, et cetera, which is what you're working on towards, you know, just the way that his mind and the way that he works for his clients and where his clients can go. Super interesting. Fab, another client, I just wanted to ask about Zlatan, because, you know, I'm wondering, you know, AC Milan, as they continue to fight Scudetto, but they're not in European competition. Is there any chance of him leaving AC Milan at the end of next year, at the end of the season? Does Mino Raiola, is he thinking about Zlatan's future even now in December?
No, there is no way for Zlatan to leave AC Milan. Zlatan wants to stay, and AC Milan want to extend the contract of Zlatan for one more season till 2023. Mm-hmm. So I can tell you that Zlatan will extend his contract with AC Milan in the coming months. Not now, but in the coming months, maybe in February, March. Why they're waiting? Because Zlatan is 40. And so you know that injuries could always be a problem when you have this kind of age and you're playing football at top level, professional level. So Zlatan is still making a difference, but injuries are something that have to be monitored every single day. So if maybe... we hope not, of course, but if in February, in March, in April, the situation will be different on injury side, they will decide together what is best to do with Zlatan. But if Zlatan will be fit and ready to continue, Zlatan will 100% sign a new deal with AC Milan.